It's going to be like tough now.
It's going to be tough?
Yeah.
The manager at Bob's Smoke Shop in Newark's Ironbound felt deserted by Juul's sudden announcement that the company will stop advertising its products in the U.S., by its CEO's abrupt resignation, and by the company's decision to stop lobbying against the Trump administration's proposed federal ban on its popular flavored vapes.
You expect that you're really going to see business go down?
Yeah, a little bit. A little bit. Not on me, but all kinds of smoke shop.
New Jersey's home to an estimated 250 vape shops, a $565 million industry. Juul's the most popular e-cigarette in the U.S., with a 72% market share as of last September. But it's been blamed for a rise in vaping among teens who prefer Juul's fruity flavors. Now the company's facing state and criminal probes into its marketing strategy to minors, as states, including New York and Michigan, have recently banned flavored vapes, and Massachusetts just yesterday banned the sale of all vape products for 4 months. Jersey's debating a ban.
It's decimating the industry. So we're seeing stores in New Jersey close because they think that we're going to be the next state to ban.
I know a guy from New York. He called me yesterday like, oh, my business is really went down. Yeah, it's like Juul's fault. They making the flavor because they know the kids like flavors.
What they did wrong, They put themselves in a situation that every single gas station in the States will sell the Juul, you know, and not every gas station will ID, you know, like underage people.
New Jersey's Vaping Rights Coalition president claimed business is off 70% to 90% in New Jersey. He called Juul the most vilified company in America, the corporate face of teen vaping.
They're kind of ducking their head now. This is a company that brought us the youth epidemic, and they don't show up at hearings.
Juul's incoming CEO noted its future is at risk due to unacceptable levels of youth usage and eroding public confidence in our industry. Against that backdrop, we must strive to work with regulators, policymakers, and other stakeholders and earn the trust of the societies in which we operate. It won't even keep running its Make the Switch ads aimed at helping cigarette smokers quit, which is why many people started vaping. Now, they're uncomfortable.
It may be better than smoking, but I feel like we're all like lab rats, kind of, being tested.
And they were trying to make as much money as they could, and now they're getting out when they see that people are starting to be severely affected by Juul.
For now, the biggest problem confronting vape shops is uncertainty, both political and economic, as reaction to the vaping epidemic continues to intensify. In Newark, I'm Brenda Flanagan, NJTV News.